Overdose on Buckley with exclusive content, early access, and more. Support the habit at patreon.com/doseofbuckley. This is Musical Autopsy. It's time once again for Doc Buckley to grab his scalpel and head on down to the musical morgue to slice up a song or artist. And today on the table, it's Taylor Swift, The Man.
I would be complex, I would be cool. They'd say I played the field before I found someone to commit to.
Ah yes, it wouldn't be a modern pop song if we had more than one production element to sing over. Did they decide that simplistic audiences need simplistic music? Go listen to a song like Nelly Furtado's Maneater or Fergie's London Bridge. Mid-2000s pop songs that probably at the time seemed pretty basic, but where there's all these little production elements. Some of them just barely noticeable. Like the little shimmer sound in London Bridge, but where they just kick off, and if you were in a club and that song comes on, it gets a reaction without even needing a remix. Meanwhile, no woo girls are getting up for Taylor Swift. I guess it's the separation of EDM and pop that's happened over the last 10 years, but it's like they're rationing sound. Okay, don't put more than one instrument or effect in the intro. The music industry's running out of sounds that some fucking artist from the 70s won't sue us for using. At this point, YouTube Studio has more interesting background music than these artists do. Now someone will say, but that's not what Taylor Swift's songs are for. Doesn't matter, it's a pop song, it gets judged against other pop songs. And The Man is clearly meant to be upbeat or something that Reddit audiences would call a bop, but it just feels so boring when compared to other bops. Maybe if the music was too distracting, it might take away from her message.
I'd be a fearless leader. I'd be an alpha type. When everyone believes ya, what's that like?
I don't know, Taylor. What is that like? You're the one that won a sexual assault case before the Me Too movement really gained momentum. It also seemed like everyone believed you before Kim Kardashian released the phone call. In fact, almost every lyric in this song probably would have been more impactful if it had been performed by someone who wasn't, like, the single most successful pop star the last two, potentially soon to be three, decades. Like, imagine this song if it was performed by someone like Bebe Rexha, who has all the elements of a top-tier star, but who has been criticized for her fluctuating weight, or has been told by executives that she's too old, at 30, to be wearing sexy outfits. All conversations that have nothing to do with her abilities. Because this whole song is about how women are unfairly judged for outside bullshit and superficial nonsense, and it can potentially hinder or distract their career. Which I'll admit, I totally believe is true. And I know, guys, you're going to say, well, what about all those Marvel guys? They only got where they are because of how hot they are. No one cares if they can act. If they were ugly, they never would have been in those movies. And yes, you're right. But then you have to explain how some potato face like Louis Capaldi managed to become so successful. Clearly, no one passed on signing this kid due to his looks. He looks like what you'd think Gary Busey looked like as a young man if you'd only ever seen Gary Busey now. Oh, well, I guess we find out why they didn't put too many production elements in there. The ones they had left laying around for the hook are just those annoying pitch-bending effects they put in fucking everything now. But every album she's put out has gone multi-platinum, even in an era where no one gives a fuck about full albums. She's one of the few who can still sell physical albums, and her audience buys them. Her album 1989 was the first album of 2014 to go platinum, and that happened in November, so nothing went platinum for the whole fucking year, until that album, and it became the best-selling album of the year. With only one exception, her very first album, every album she's put out has a song that hit number one, number two, or number three. Those six albums, spanning 12 years, have all been number one. Name another currently active artist who could do all that, or who has done all that. She was a millionaire in her teens. How much quicker could she have got there if she was a man? Does she believe that if she had been born with a dick, she'd have been set for life by like 11 instead of 16? In fact, let's compare her to some men. At the age of 30 years old, Taylor Swift has had 25 top 10 hits according to Wikipedia, and 96 top 100 hits. More than Justin Timberlake, Justin Bieber, Bruno Mars, and even more than the Beatles or the Rolling Stones. She already is the fucking man. Ooh, it's adult Taylor Swift time. Well, maybe I'm more of an ally than I thought, since I've been making fun of male artists who brag about how much money they have and how many women they get for fucking years. It's one of the laziest and most overdone tropes in music. There's nothing creative left to say about it. But a few parts of this song, and most of the video, seem to be her complaining that she can't be an asshole like men can be. Scenes of her dressed as a guy man-spreading and smoking on a subway, pissing on a wall, being a douchebag at work, and a total cock to subordinates. Nobody likes these people. Nobody respects them. Like, does she think that Martin Shkreli was one of the most well-respected individuals of our time? Is that what she's upset about? That she can't be rich and a piece of shit? She specifically mentions Leonardo DiCaprio, referencing his parties and much younger girlfriends he vacations with in some fucking place in France where only rich assholes go. And despite Leo getting dragged for it on Twitter all the time, she's upset that she can't behave this way without meaningless nobodies on social media being mad at her? Well, guess what? Us meaningless nobodies, we all hate the rich, no matter their gender, so you wouldn't win either way. They wouldn't shake their heads and question how much of this I deserve. And that is why we hate them. None of you deserve any of it, male or female. Did you manage to be one of the millions of wannabe singers who got lucky with a marketable look and being born to the right people, with the right genes, and managing to make the right contacts, when realistically there's 10,000 other people in that group who could possibly have been in the exact same spot you are if they got lucky? Great. Fucking happy for you. And if people want to give you money for you to perform because they enjoy what you do and they see value in that, then as an entertainer myself, I'm glad that's working out for you. I really am. Not sarcasm, absolutely thrilled that Taylor Swift is doing well. But if you're upset that you don't have the total respect of every living person, that because you're on top, people on the internet who don't like you talk shit about your life or your looks, just like they talked shit about Elvis's hips or scrutinized Michael Jackson's bizarre life or appearance before they thought he was a pedo, or even questioned how deserving Lil Nas X was of his fame for a horse rap song. Seriously, if this makes you sad, fucking cry about it, and dry your eyes with the insignificant cash in your pocket, or as the rest of us would know it, a mortgage payment. This is Musical Autopsy. Bag it and tag it.